Sometimes justice comes later than we would hope.
But nearly a decade after the chilling abduction and killing of 10-year-old Anthony Martinez of Beaumont, prosecutors announced Thursday,
we will seek the death penalty.
We finally came up with the conclusion that we would stand by whatever the district attorney decided to do in the case of Joseph Duncan, provided that Joseph Duncan never see the light of day again.
On April 4, 1997, a man matching this description lured Anthony from the alley behind his home and into this car. Longtime Beaumont resident Mary Daniel remembers hundreds of volunteers manning phone banks and helping in the search.
Not knowing who. Was it a neighbor? Was it somebody who lived here? I don't think anybody ever gave up. You know, which is nice in a small town.
15 days after the search started, it ended when a forest ranger found Anthony's nude body among the rocks of the Indio Hills.
A few leads to go on. If you don't have a piece of evidence or an eyewitness, it's hard to link the killer to his victim, and that's what makes serial killers so hard to catch.
The Anthony Martinez case got a major break in the summer of 2005 when a 9-year-old girl from Idaho who'd been abducted by a serial killer told police that killer had admitted to leaving the body of a small child in the desert of Riverside County in 1997.
She's lucky to be alive and certainly a brave, brave girl.
Authorities won't elaborate on what Shasta Groney told the FBI about Joseph Duncan's confession, but it led to the matching of Duncan's partial thumbprint on a piece of duct tape that bound Anthony's body.
This guy's the epitome of the sexual predator that is a nightmare for all of us.
Last October, Duncan pleaded guilty to murdering Shasta's family in Idaho, and authorities believe his trail of molestation and torture extends across the West. Whether through this trial or others, the nightmare may be over.